beautiful people, welcome back to the Canada Info Up channel. It's me, your girl Rolo. I'm so sorry. First of all, I have to apologize to you guys. I am so sorry. I was supposed to upload videos on Sunday and yesterday, but I was so tired. I needed to take a break, guys. So how are you doing? I hope you're doing well. I hope everything is fine. I know that lots of preparations are ongoing because we are practically moving towards the end of the year and so many activities in different parts of the world. In this part of the world, it is very quiet, like so quiet, because of what is going on, and you know, everybody's afraid of catching the virus, so we just have to be, you know, we have to protect ourselves by not going out. There's lockdown even in Manitoba. Some provinces are announcing lockdown as well. So yeah, so that's it. So welcome back to today's video, and if you're new to this channel, welcome, and please subscribe, and guess what, do the next thing, just give me the thumbs up. To all of my returning subscribers, to all my Canadian squad, future Canadians, people planning to come to Canada, all of you guys, thank you so much. And of course, you know what to do now, just give me the thumbs up. Don't scatter your photo, but just give me the thumbs up wherever you are. Okay, so today's video is as a result of the live video I did on Saturday, and I said I was going to do some videos, so this is one of them. And the question was where to search for jobs. If you're going to be a newcomer coming to Canada, where you should start searching for jobs. Now, the popular website, the number one website which people go to search for jobs, is the Job Bank. It is a website created by the government of Canada, and it is very popular. Almost all organizations in Canada put their adverts on Job Bank. The next popular website is Indeed. You'll be seeing the websites as I'm talking about them, and it is very popular because people also go to search for jobs there. The next website, would I say website or social media site that people search for jobs and get jobs, is LinkedIn. So LinkedIn is very peculiar because it's a social media site where you have professionals hanging out, professionals meeting different professionals and all that. And people use it as a networking tool to network with, you know, recruiters, network with hiring managers, network with directors. So if you are LinkedIn and you're looking to come to Canada and you are looking for a job, maybe one of these high-skilled jobs as a software developer, and you've been finding it difficult getting traction, what you should do is actually look for the directors of the companies you have applied to, search for their names on LinkedIn, and if you can find their name on LinkedIn, connect with them on LinkedIn. Once you connect with them on LinkedIn, if they are very active on LinkedIn, you should also be active as well by responding to their comments, responding to their posts, just to create that visibility for yourself. Once you do that, they'll be able to notice you, and you can now talk about yourself. You can now introduce yourself to the directors, and if there is an opportunity open for you, you could get a job offer from LinkedIn. People use LinkedIn so much, and I see it as a way of connecting with people. Even if you're not looking for a job, just connect with people. If you're not a social person, you just have to put yourself out there, because the job market is tough itself, you know, and it's a full-time job. You cannot just send out one resume expecting somebody to contact you. You have to like go all out. You have to be visible. You have to knock the doors. If it means pushing the doors open, you have to push the doors open. If I talk about LinkedIn, it's going to take a lot of my time because there's so much strategy that goes with being visible on LinkedIn and trying to get a job offer from LinkedIn. Anyway, so that's by the way for LinkedIn. Maybe I'll do a separate video about how to network on LinkedIn and how you can connect with employers and get your job offers from LinkedIn. The next websites people look for jobs are the provincial government job sites. The provincial governments, they have their own job websites, especially for government jobs. This is specifically for government jobs. For Saskatchewan, they have what you call Sask Jobs. So if you go to Sask Jobs, you will see both government and private organizations advertising on Sask Jobs. For Manitoba government jobs, it's just Manitoba government jobs that you find on that website. You'll not see anything related to private jobs on Manitoba government jobs website. And for Ontario jobs, the same thing. Alberta jobs, go to, if you want anything related to government Alberta jobs, Ontario jobs, just put the province and put the government jobs, you see them popping up. I'll leave the links in the description box of this video so you search them out. So if you have gotten your visa and you're planning to come to Canada, this is what you should do. Start searching for jobs even before you land. Start sending your resume. Try as much as possible to get an address in the location where you're going to, get an international number and start applying for these jobs. Then, apart from the provincial government jobs website, which I talked about, you can also search for jobs on some other popular sites like Career Beacon, Workopolis, Monster, Eluta, Job Boom. Job Boom is specifically for people going to Quebec. So if you're going to Quebec, target your job search using Job Boom. It's a French job site where you can get jobs from. So these job sites are where you can search for jobs from. Instead of just focusing on only Indeed, try as much as possible to spread your tentacles amongst all these websites. I'll be leaving the links in the description box of this video. And once you start doing that, if you're able to get an employer talking to you, then it's fine. I know it's very difficult getting a job from outside Canada, but there are certain jobs you can get from outside Canada, which I have talked about in my videos before. Agricultural jobs, you can get them from outside Canada because they're looking for workers. Home care, child caregiver jobs. So the next group of people that can get jobs from outside Canada are software developers. So software developers, information technology experts. If you want to search for a job, use all these websites to search for jobs and start networking via LinkedIn as well. Then another group of people that can get jobs from outside Canada are the low-skilled workers, like people who work in the hospitality industry. These kind of people, they also get jobs. But because of COVID-19, the hospitality industry is down, so you can't get such jobs from outside Canada. The construction industry also, you can get such jobs from outside Canada. But because of COVID-19, you can't get such jobs from outside Canada now. So if your occupation falls under any of these categories, you can search for jobs using this website. If you are someone who has gotten his or her copy of permanent residency and you're outside Canada, you're here to come to Canada, use this website to start searching for jobs so that you don't come to Canada and start your job search. You can start your job search from outside Canada. I've talked about it before. I did this video so that I can explain this website and show you this website, number one. My next video will be about your AIPP strategy. For those who want to come to Canada under AIPP, it will be the strategy on getting a job offer through AIPP and also getting a job offer through RNIP. Although RNIP is quite straightforward because the jobs are actually advertised on the community portal compared to AIPP. AIPP, you have to do an individual search of the employers first. You have to search on their website first and see how you can connect with the employers. So I'll do the video of AIPP job search strategy for 2021. That will be my next video. I pray I have time. I don't know if I'm going to have time to do the video tomorrow. I have so many things I am doing. Anyway, I pray I have the time to do that so that you will be aware and you can start preparing on how you can, you know, search for your jobs and immigrate either through RNIP or through AIPP or maybe any of these means and come to Canada. So that's the information I want to share today. I hope you find it useful, and I would ask that you share with your friends and families. Don't be stingy. Don't be stingy. Share with your friends and family, and see you in my next video. Hopefully, I'm keeping my fingers crossed, and I'm praying for energy. Okay, see you in my next video. Bye.